I welcome you all to this session. This is the third sem mechanical engineering course. Today we will discuss about the thermal engineering subject. And in the thermal engineering, we will discuss about the fuel and combustion, that is your chapter 6. These are the content of the chapters, that what is the definition of fuel, what are the types of fuel, what are the application of different types of fuel, heating value of fuel. Then quality of ICE engine fuel, that is octane number and cetane number, that we will discuss in this chapter. So first we will go for discussing what is fuel. Fuel are those substances which when burn in the presence of air, it generates heat. That we know. In the ICE engine also, the petrol will be burned in presence of your air. Diesel will be burned in presence of air. From that we are getting the heat. From the heat we get the work. So what is fuel? Fuel which is burned in presence of air that generate heat, and this heat is converted to work, and finally we get work. Okay. So what are the classification of fuel? Fuel are classified into three types, that is solid, liquid and gaseous fuel. So which fuels are the solid fuel? The fuels which appear in the solid state, for example coal, wood, charcoal, anthracite, bituminous, these are the which fuels? Solid fuel. And what which one is the liquid fuel? That fuel which appear in the liquid state, that is your liquid fuel, that is crude oil, petrol, diesel, kerosene. So crude oil is the original form of oil which we get from the sea level and under the sea, and this crude oil will be distilled or it will be filtered, then we get the kerosene, diesel, petrol that we get. Then we will discuss the gaseous fuel. What gaseous fuel? Gaseous fuel which are the fuel which appear in the gaseous. And you know your household LPG gas, that is liquefied petroleum gas. So that is also a gaseous fuel, natural gas, biogas, methane, ethane. So nowadays the CNG auto are running, that is your compressed natural gas. The autos are running here. So these are the form of your gaseous fuel. Then the fuel which is suitable for the chemical reaction, that was to be used in the ICE engine. What are the fuel? The fuel are the hydrocarbon fuel. Fuel which contain hydrogen and carbon are the main constituent, that is known as your hydrocarbon fuel. The hydrocarbon fuel derived from the crude petroleum by proper refining processes as thermal catalytic cracking method and polymerization, alkalization, isomerization and reforming and blending. So as I told you that we get which oil? We get crude oil, and the crude oil will be refined by many processes, that thermal catalytic cracking, polymerization, alkalizing, isomerizing, reforming and blending. So in this process the crude oil will be filtered or refined, then we got your petrol, diesel and kerosene from that. And one example of your hydrocarbon fuel I am giving, that is CH4 methane. Okay. Then we will discuss about what are the alternative fuel. Alternative fuel, that is alcohol. Alcohol means methanol, ethanol. Natural gas, that is methane, LPG, that propane and butane, hydrogen, and liquid hydrocarbon. The engine fuel are mainly mixture of hydrocarbon with bond between hydrogen and carbon atom. During combustion, these bonds are broken and new bond are formed with oxygen atom. Because the fuel will be burned in presence of air. What is in the air? Air is in, oxygen is in the air. So in presence of oxygen, the fuel will be burned. So when will be burn the hydrogen and carbon fuel, hydrocarbon fuel in presence of your oxygen, that we got different new bundles and accomplished by release chemical energy. The principal product of carbon dioxide and water vapor. So suppose we have to burn any fuel, that is CH4, in presence of oxygen, then what you get? We get carbon dioxide and we get water vapor, that we get from the which that the by burning of fuel. Suppose we are burning CH4 in presence of your oxygen. What we get? We get as a product of carbon dioxide and the water vapor, that is H2O, that we get by combustion. And the fuel are contains small amount of sulfur, oxygen, nitrogen, water. And the different constituents of crude petroleum which are available in the liquid hydrocarbon are paraffin, naphthalene, naphthenes, olefins and aromatic. So these are also constituent we get from the crude oil. Basically, the fuel are of hydrogen and carbon. Then we will discuss application of different types of fuel. What is it will be applicable? You know the fuels are solid, gaseous, and liquid. Where you can use solid fuel, the common coal used in the Indian industry are bituminous and soft bituminous coal. Gaseous fuel are commonly used as are liquefied petroleum gas, LPG, natural gas, producer gas, blast furnace gas, coke oven gas, etc. The calorific value of gaseous fuel is expressed in terms of kilocalorie per normal cubic centimeter. And at normal temperature 20 degree and pressure of 760 mmHg, we will describe the calorific value of the gaseous fuel. What are the liquid fuel? Liquid fuel that is used in the ICE engine and industrial purpose, that is petrol engine, diesel engine, petrol, diesel, these are the liquid fuels that are used in the engines, petrol engine, diesel engine. Then we will discuss about the combustion. What is combustion? Combustion is the conversion of substance called fuel into chemical compound known as product of combustion or by combination with an oxidizer. You know that? If I burn the fuel, how we will burn the fuel? The fuel will be burned in presence of air. Air, what is air inside the air? Air and oxygen. Oxygen is the main compound which will help to burn the fuel. Okay. So, what is combustion? Combustion means conversion of the substance or fuel into chemical compound known as the product of combustion, or we can say that is the combination of oxidizer. The product of combustion also may call combination of oxidizer. The combustion process is an exothermic chemical reaction. Exothermic means from where we get the heat. That is a reaction that releases energy as it occurs. Thus, combustion may be expressed symbolically by fuel plus oxidizer product of combustion plus energy. Here, the fuel and oxidizer are the reactant. That is, the substance present before the reaction takes place. This relation indicates that reactant produce combustion product and energy. The fuel produces what? Combustion product and energy. Either the chemical energy release is transferred to the surrounding as it produced, or it remains in the combustion product to form the elevated energy. So the product after burning the fuel, what you get? We get the oxidizer product of combustion, this and energy. This chemical energy is either released to the surrounding or it may be elevated in the, it may be remain in the combustion product in terms of your internal energy. Okay. Or some combustion. So that is the function of combustion, and by the combustion we get what? We get energy, and this energy will be converted to what? So what we will combust? We have to burn the fuel in presence of air, that is known as a combustion. Then fuel are evaluated in part based on the amount of energy or heat that may be released per unit mass or per mole during the combustion of fuel. Such quantity is known as your fuel heat of reaction or heating heat. If we burn the fuel, what do you get? We get some amount of energy. The amount of energy released per unit mass per or per mole during combustion of the fuel, such quantity is known as your what? Heat of reaction, or that is also known as your heating value. The heat of reaction may be measured in the calorimeter. This heating value will be measured in term in a calorimeter. And what is calorimeter? A device in which chemical energy release is determined by transferring the release heat to the surrounding fuel, that is known as your what? Calorimeter. The amount of heat transferred to the fluid in returning the product of combustion to their initial temperature yield the heat of reaction. Okay. So what is the function of calorimeter? The heat of reaction or heating well will be measured in the calorimeter. What is calorimeter? A device in which chemical energy release is determined by transferring the release heat to the surrounding, and the amount of heat transferred to the fluid, surrounding fluid, is returning to the product of combustion to their initial temperature. So, if I burn something, that will get some energy, chemical energy, and this chemical energy will be released to the surrounding. And if this this compound or product of combustion will be, then it will be returning to the initial temperature. So, of the heating reaction, so that is that we get from the which value? That is the function of a calorimeter, that from where we can measure the heating value. So that means how you evaluate the fuel? The amount of energy that will be generated by burning of the fuel per unit mass or per unit mole, that is known as the heating value. So how we measure the heating value? Heating value will be measured by the calorimeter. So how the calorimeter will be measured the value? The chemical energy that will be released by the burning of fuel, that will be transported to the surrounding. And that will be again cooled to the room temperature by heating reaction. That is, in this way, the calorimeter will be measured the heating value of the fuel, any fuel. Then we will discuss about what is calorific value. It is defined as the total amount of heat liberated or heat released when a unit mass of fuel is burned completely. It is identify the efficiency of the fuel. Calorific value can be measured by the following unit, that is kilocalorie per kg for solid or liquid fuel, kilocalorie per meter cube, that is for gaseous fuel. With fuel content hydrogen and two calorific value are discussed. With fuel content containing hydrogen, the two calorific value are distinguished. So what are this? Higher or gross calorific value, that is known as your higher heating value. Lower or net calorific value, that is also known as your lower heating value. So next we will discuss about higher and gross calorific value or higher heating value. So what is that calorific value? If the total amount of heat released by when burning unit mass of a fuel, that is known as your calorific value. If in the fuel the hydrogen is present, then we can divide the calorific value into two types. Okay? So what are they? Higher or gross calorific value or higher heating value. So what do you mean by higher heating value? As I told you before, that when you are burning the fuel in presence of your oxygen, what you get? We get the some product of combustion and we get some water vapor. And if I cool this water vapor to the room temperature, that is known as your what? Heating value. So what do you mean by higher heating value? It is defined as the total amount of heat liberated or released when a unit mass of fuel is burned completely and the product of combustion are cooled to room temperature. When a fuel containing hydrogen is burned, the hydrogen is converted to steam. So as we know that during combustion, what you get? You get the product of combustion and water vapor. And if I cool the water vapor, then it will be converted to hydrogen, converted to what? It will be converted to steam. So when we burn the hydrogen fuel, then it will be converted to what? Water vapor, that means steam. If the combustion product are cooled to room temperature, the steam is get condensed into water and latent heat is absorbed. So in the steam means what? The steam having some heat content? So no. So if I cool into room temperature, it will be condensed to what? It will be cooled to water. If the steam will be condensed or cooled, that will be converted to what? Water. And latent heat is evolved in the water. And the latent heat of condensation of steam is also included in the gross calorific value. So that is known as your what? Higher heating value. Okay. A good fuel possesses higher heat calorific value, or that we can say higher heating value. So basically, what is higher heating value? If I burn any amount of fuel, total amount of heat released by burning unit mass of fuel, then what you got? We got product of combustion and some water vapor. And if I cool the water vapor in a room temperature, what do you get? You get the steam, you get the water, and this water has some heat, so that is known as which heat? Latent heat. And this latent heat means has some energy, and if it will be included in this, if this latent heat of condensation of steam is also included in the energy, so that is known as what? Gross calorific value, or that is known as good fuel possesses what? Higher calorific value. Or you can say higher heating value. Okay. For example, as I say, so say if I burn CH4 in presence of your oxygen or air, so what we get product? We get the product of carbon dioxide, that is the product of combustion, and what we get? We get water vapor, that is H2O. So if I cool, that is your steam. So what is heating value? If I cool into the, we get this one by burning of fuel. If the water vapor will be cooled to room temperature, then what do you get? We get the H2O in the form of what? Water. And this water has some what? Latent heat, hidden form of heat. If the latent heat will be added in this energy, and we get also from what? We get some energy.